Right, so this is a tutorial for Take Me Home Country Roads by John Denver. We're going to go over the chord progression, which is A, F sharp minor, E, D, and E. And then the chorus, which is A, E, F sharp minor, D, A. So also it's going to cover the A finger picking pattern, so which is with the right hand here. Well, you can't see very well. So we go. So yeah, just that one, and then we're also going to cover like a brief. Briefly cover the A pentatonic scale in major form, but this shape. So, starting off, use country strum number one. So, I do that down, so down, 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 up, down. So we go. Technically speaking, the timing would be 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, clap it. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And as we know, to make things interesting, you hit the root notes on the 1. So we go 1, 2. So we go like that. 2. And four. So we go 1, 2, 3, and four. 1, 2, 3, and four. Okay, so with the progression here, we've got two bars of each chord. So as the progression goes, we've got for the verse, we've got A, F sharp minor, E, D, back to A. Okay, so now this is what we're going to do. We're going to, I'll just run through it quickly. One. So it's pretty straightforward. So if we're counting, remember, taking into account country strum number one, down, 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 up, down. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now let's play it. Starting on the A. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now let's do two cycles of each one. So we're going to do two cycles of A, two cycles of F sharp minor, two cycles of E, one cycle of D, and then another two cycles of A. So 1, 2, 3, 4. F sharp minor is coming next. E. D, one cycle. Back to A. Great, okay, so that's the verse covered in terms of chords. Now let's quickly run through the chorus. Each one of these also has two cycles of country strum number one. So we're going to go A. It's very similar to the verse, but the chords are in a slightly different order. So we're going to go A, E, F sharp, minor, D, and then we're going to go A, E, D, and then back to A. Each one has two cycles, and country strum number one, like we've discussed. So let's try it from A. One, two, three, four. So we've got two cycles. To E. F sharp minor. D. Okay, so now we've covered the verse and the chorus for the tune. So and real and full, like, you should always work on building your tempo up to the speed of the recording or the person that you're playing with, or a tempo that you're just happy playing with on your own. There's links below this talking about the various topics like timing, and building your tempos up. So click on them and have a read. But for now, I'm just going to quickly run through at the tempo that you should be aiming to get to. So we're counting 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the verse. Chorus. Excuse my singing voice. I had a gig last night, so things are... Not that it sounds good anyway, but it sounds worse today. Okay, so now let's try a finger-picking pattern. We all know the right-hand rule. The right-hand rule is thumb covers these three, and then index is on the third string, middle is on the second string, and ring fingers on the first string, right? So technically, that's what it should look like. So going slow. Obviously, rules are made to be broken, but this time we're not going to break the rules. We're going to stick with them. Okay, so now this is a very generic country finger-picking pattern. It goes like this. Okay, so now my right hand, to see closer what that's doing, right? So we're going to go, so we're going, and then with that finger. So we go thumb, and then thumb, index. So there's two parts to this. That's the first part. And then, which is your third finger, like that. So we go, and then, so try that. Okay, slow. Okay, and then, so the last one's thumb, index, so. Slowly. Even slower. 2, 3, 4. Okay, so now you always hit the root. So you get the idea. Now we've got we've got some alternative chords to use as well. So if you're playing with your friends and you know you want to sound different. There's another link to another blog post that I've written about playing with your friends and playing interesting keeping it interesting, you know, so you're both playing different things. So one person... Whereas the next person could be doing this. It just keeps it interesting for everyone. So, what we're going to use now is we're just going to use like standard bar chords. Like I think technically they're called roots. This is a root six, which I call an E shape, which is derived from E. Like there'll be a caged explanation like in a further tutorial. But yeah, like it's an E and it's just moved up to A. Just a standard bar chord. Everyone seems to default to this one. So that's an A on the 5th fret, using that one, right? And then we've got an F sharp minor, which is on the 9th fret, like that, and it's derived from an A, again, which is caged. Isn't that a beautiful A mono? So, derived from A minor, we bar it, and then we move it all the way up to the 9th fret. Isn't that beautiful? So we've got A here, we've got F sharp minor here, and then we've got E here, which is just the A shaped bar chord, but a lot of people finger it like this, or finger it like that. But if you've got like big fingers like me, you just do it like that. But just make sure you've got that arch there, so you've got the first string ringing out. Like a lot of people made the mistake of doing that, which you know, it's not wrong. I think it's an E6 there, but we want to make it sound complete, like a major. Okay, so we've got A so far, F sharp minor, E, which also you can use a power chord, so you're just using, and then you've got two open strings, which actually sounds quite beautiful. And then we've got D, which we can do here, which is the same as E, just down two frets. Or check this out, which is just taking these three from the D, which is on the 7th fret, taking that part of it, this part, and just using one of these fingers and barring all three of these. So watch this. So bar it, and then bar the bottom two on the 10th fret. And that's also a D, which sounds quite pretty. So we've got A, F sharp minor, E, finger like that, but we're going to finger like this, or we can play it like this. And then we've got D, oops, like that, and then back to A. Get to that another time. That one, so but that one. So yeah, they're the alternative voicings that you can use, right? Okay, so now one final thing. I always like to show how, like, this is in the key of A, right? And everyone seems to like scale knowledge seems to be some kind of archaic thing where everyone's kind of like, oh, modes and this and that and rah rah, but it's quite a simple concept. Like if you know the blues scale, you know, technically speaking, you know both a major and a minor scale. So the blues scale, just to refresh it for everyone, we'll do it in F sharp, so the 2nd fret. So that's 2-5, 2-4, 2-4, 2-4, 2-5, 2-5. So, okay, so that's minor, right? Now, if we do exactly the same thing, playing these notes, but instead of starting with this finger, our index finger, we start with our pinky finger, playing exactly the same notes. So it changes it from an F sharp to an A. Right? Okay, so... So we've got F sharp minor, which is just the standard blues shape, and A major. But for the sake of this exercise, we're just going to make it an A. Right. And so now, just a quick note on phrasing. So, first of all, so let's like apply the scale. Like, so you've got your friend playing, or you've created a backing track for yourself. You've got like the whole West Virginia thing going, Gorge Mountains, Shenandoah's River, and you're like, cool, I want to do some, so that's the, I mean, obviously that's, like me just like nutting off, which I don't expect you to do, but even, you know, you've got the correct notes to play now, and you can play off in your own time. And a really good thing to do, the final thing, is to close the phrase. Like, so if we make this a phrase is like a sentence, right? So let's make the simplest sentence possible, which is this: just run the scale and then close it by hitting that one. And it's a very country thing to do. Well, not country, more bluegrass, but, you know. Right, so, in sum, this lesson has gone through the chord progression for Take Me Home, Country Roads, which is A, twice, also with the F-sharp minor E, D, one, back to A. And the chorus, A, E, F sharp minor, D, A, E, D, A. We've also covered the finger picking pattern, so. Also covered alternative chords. So we've got and then we've covered the scale. Right, I hope that's useful.